Hello, welcome to another how-to video. In this video, I'm going to be showing how to make your very own iPod charger from just a few simple parts that runs off of the wall outlet. It puts out about 4.9 volts to 5.3 volts at about 500 milliamps. And it uses all in all maybe about 7, 8 parts, maybe less than that. Depends on if you have a rectifier or not. I would just recommend getting the parts that you need. This will be a very quick video. And I will tell you the supplies right now, what you need to build this. Okay, for this video, you'll need a breadboard with some jumper cables, a 120 volt to 12.6 volt 300 milliamp transformer. This was $5 at Radio Shack. I don't have the part number, but just go to Radio Shack and get one. This is a 100 volt 1500 milliamp bridge rectifier. If not, you can just use four diodes in the rectifier combination, which is right here. As you can see, you have the AC in goes here, and the DC out goes here, positive and negative. Very simple, just use like four 1N 4001 through 006 diodes. But this is a simple bridge rectifier. It's pretty small. I'm just going to use that since it's much easier. So we have that, the transformer. A 5 volt voltage regulator. This is an LM7805. It's a 78XX series. You can get it for about $2 at Radio Shack. It's called a 5 volt regulator. And what it does is it puts out 5 volts at a stable output so it won't blow anything in your iPod. And mounted on a heatsink, this is not an adequate heatsink for this device. This needs a bigger heatsink, preferably this heatsink. But I'm missing the screw for it. So this can run about 2 minutes on this heatsink, which is all we'll need to demonstrate how it works. You're going to need two 0.1 microfarad capacitors. The code on them is 104, and they come in this polypropylene or something, this film type ceramic. And you also need an electrolytic 470 microfarad capacitor at about 16 volts or higher. That's what I have. And obviously you're going to need a cord that plugs into your AC wall outlet that I have here. You're going to need some way to attach it to the pins on the bottom of the transformer. Alright, let's get to building this thing. First you got to take your transformer and find the 120 volt side. If you have an unlabeled transformer that you know is 12 volts, or it says 12 volts, you don't know which side is which, what you do is you take a battery like this. So let's say we're going to put it on the 12 volt side first, and it will just, this is a 6 volt battery, just go like this. See, I'm getting a spark there. You may not be able to see it, but I am getting a spark. That means that this is the low voltage end, and on the higher voltage end, which is the wall input, you will get no spark. See, I'm not getting, well, I'm getting a little spark, but it's much more of a smaller spark. Because this is has a higher amount of windings, this is a lower amount of windings. Okay, so on your 120 volt side, which is here, you want to attach the two ends of your wall plug. I just have a jumper clip, and I also have this piece of wire. I'm just going to wind around it. And it's pretty good. It's a good idea to insulate this just to keep it from shorting in case it ever shorts. And you want to stick the low voltage ends in your breadboard somewhere, preferably at the end of your breadboard. Make sure everything's attached. Okay, that's good. I think it's good. There we go. And then what you want to do is your rectifier has two ends where the AC is, and then two ends where the DC is. You want to find the AC ends. And if you see on this rectifier, there's a little plus right by my thumb. The plus and the negative are across from each other, and then the other two sides are the AC. So it goes plus DC, minus DC, AC, AC. So what I did was I bend them out so that the AC leads are on the outside and the DC leads are on the inside. I recommend doing that. And what you want to do is you want to stick both of the AC leads in one end of your transformer's output. I guess that'll work. Might have to fool around with bending it a little bit, but it should work. And then you got two DC outputs. Just stick them in your breadboard somewhere. Because you're going to end up taking them both to the positive and negative rails with the jumper cord. Stick this in there. Yep, this one came out. No, it didn't. No, alright, we're good. So once you got that figured out, so the positive is this end. So this end goes to the positive rail. We'll use this positive and negative rail for no reason. And then the negative side, which is over here, that goes to the negative rail. I have a positive rail that's blue and a negative rail that's red. I don't know if it might be the same on yours, but I don't know. Maybe different. Doesn't matter. All the same. Stick that in the positive rail. Okay, did I do that right? No, I did that wrong hand. Yeah, let's just use this one. Alright, we're good. Now, once you got the transformer all situated and figured out, next you want to start putting the components in. First, take that 470 microfarad capacitor rated at 16 volts or higher. Now plug the negative into the negative rail and the positive into the positive rail. Like that. Okay, next take one of your 0.1 microfarad capacitors and just plug it into your positive and negative rail. One lead goes to the positive, one lead goes to the negative. Like that. Now here's a little bit of a tricky part. You want to stick your voltage regulator somewhere in here. Now the pins go like this. 1, 2, 3. In, voltage in, voltage ground, voltage out. So you want to remember that. Okay, let's just stick it there. Okay, so the voltage in, which is the first pin, goes to the positive rail. So you're just going to take a jumper cable. Let's take a smaller one. Take it from the positive rail to pin 1. Okay. And the second pin will go to the negative rail, which is the ground pin of your 7805 voltage regulator. Now the third pin is the voltage out pin. So you can just take a jumper cable, I guess, and move it towards the two rails here. You might want to put in one closer to the middle of your breadboard. Then take your last 0.1 microfarad capacitor, take it from the negative rail to the voltage out pin of your regulator. And that is pretty much it. You're going to want to also have this type of cord with you, which is right here. It's an iPod adapter cord with two bare wires at the end. So you're going to want to strip the bare wires at the end. I would take some thicker wire from each end. Just plug it in, one from the negative rail, and then maybe another to the positive rail right here. Stick two of them in. I'll zoom out. And take the positive, which is the red, to the positive output of your circuit. Take the negative to the negative output of your circuit. Just wrap it around. Make sure nothing is touching or shorting out. Make sure your transformer is all connected and stuff. I already tested this with my voltage meter, but before you do this, you should, if you don't have a voltage meter, find a way to test without plugging into your iPod to see if you get 4-point-something volts out. So that's why I'm going to test right now with my multimeter. Turn it to 20 volts DC. My multimeter always says negative voltage, even if it's the correct way. It always says negative. Let's plug it in. Okay. Touch the two output leads. And get them up. 4.9 to 5 volts. So that's good. So turn off your multimeter. Take your iPod. Plug it into the correct way. And you get that little charging symbol, I think. Yep, that little charging symbol means that it's charging. And it draws about 400 milliamps. It only needs 300. So it's pretty normal charge rate for the circuit. But yeah, it's a very simple circuit. If you touch the voltage regulator, it gets really hot after a while. But not yet. So that's why you need the adequate heatsink, which is about this big. It's like, this is a 2-inch by 2.5, 2-inch by 3-inch heatsink. Yeah, it's 2 inches by 2.5. All right, so here we go. I have it all on a permanent board now, prototyping board. Here's the transformer, rectifier, 3 capacitors, voltage regulator. I added an LED and a 680-ohm resistor. And 680 ohms is the proper resistance for a power LED on 5 volts input. I'll plug it in. Zoom out so you can see me plug this in. There we go. Turn it this way. And the iPod is, let's see, charging. Little charge symbol. This is a fast charge too. I didn't expect it to be this fast. What I did with the heat sinks is I doubled up two heat sinks. There's a diode heat sink right here, and then a transistor heat sink on the other side. So I just doubled them up and held them together with a screw. And that is that's pretty much it. If you got any questions or anything, plus another reason why I added the LED. Okay, that's weird. Another reason why I added the LED is, watch, I'm going to unplug it right now. What it does is, this can have some, the capacitors, they hold a charge, and you'll get yourself a pretty good shock if you don't add this LED, because the LED drains out the capacitors, and the capacitors can hold a charge for up to about 3 minutes afterwards. It may not sound like a lot, but if you're not paying attention and you touch the bottom after 3 minutes, then get a nasty shock. I bolted down the transformer with 2 bolts. It's a good idea, just to keep it in place. Yeah, everything else is pretty much secure except for this. I gotta find a way to hot glue that in, and this too. But yeah, that's pretty much it. If you have any questions or want more videos, just like and rate. Thanks.